I wanted to start this video off with one of my favorite quotes, and it says this: Henry Ford once made a wise remark to the effect that experience is the thing of supreme value in life. That is true only if one is willing to turn the past to good account. We grow by our willingness to face and rectify errors and convert them into assets. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel, the whole point of my channel is trying to take a look at the YouTube community, all this mess that's going on, and try to take that and turn it into a message. So if you're into that stuff, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. So hopefully this is the last video I'll be doing on the whole James Charles, Tati Westbrook, and Jeffree Star situation, all right? I'm tired of it, you're tired of it, but the reason I've been following it is because there's so many lessons that we can learn about our own friendships, about how we behave as a society as a whole, all of that stuff. So make sure you stay tuned because I have some awesome collabs coming up for Mental Health Awareness Month, so make sure that you're staying tuned. All right, so yeah, in this video, I wanted to kind of wrap things up and discuss kind of my final thoughts on this situation, all right? Because, you know, originally I was gonna make this video about like the winners and losers of this situation, but like at the end of the day, when I really look at it, I think everybody lost, all right? So I wanna just kind of go through each person involved as well as some people that you might not expect and kind of give my final thoughts, all right? So Tati Westbrook. All right, so in all honesty, like I've said this since the beginning, I don't think Tati Westbrook had the malicious intent going into this thing that some people are accusing her of now. There is a lot of blood money that's been made off of this situation, but I don't think that was her intent, all right? And like I said in the intro of this video, like that quote is, we take these things, we take these screw-ups, these things that we've done, and we try to convert them into assets so we can learn and grow as people. In Tati Westbrook's situation, it really looks like it was somebody who felt betrayed by a friend, her emotions got the best of her, and she felt the need to vocalize this. All of us do this, right? All of us have fallen victim to our own emotions in a situation, and we want to speak out about it to maybe friends or family members, or in Tati Westbrook's case, her audience, to just tell everybody how we've been wronged. We've been wronged and we wanna know that we're not crazy, and that's one of the reasons why we vocalize it. And I really think that Tati Westbrook made that video to try to get people to side with her. I don't think she was looking for a pity party or anything like that, but I think it's just human nature to try to get people to have our back and just be like, I got screwed over. Like, yo, right? So I think that's how it happened, and this thing escalated beyond what she could have ever, ever, ever imagined. But my final thoughts on Tati Westbrook, and I'm laughing right now because I never thought in a million years I would agree with FaZe Banks on something, but FaZe Banks just made a video discussing the money that was involved in this. And this is something that I think a lot of YouTubers and entrepreneurs are looking at in this situation, right? We're looking at like, you know, like what was the money made? Like what was the subscribers made? What does this do for somebody's brand? But anyways, FaZe Banks broke it down. It's not super hard math, but anyways, Tati Westbrook, she sells her vitamins for $40, all right? And her video on James Charles, by sister, which I believe somebody said she's since then taken down, but she had 49 million views, and at the top line of her description had her vitamins, all right? If even 1% of the people who watched her video bought vitamins, that's $19 million in sales, okay? And these vitamins are meant to be taken for a while, so people might still be taking those vitamins. Now, something that FaZe Banks brought up is, even if it was less than 1%, even if it was a fraction of 1%, there's millions of dollars right there, okay? I do believe Tati in her last video where she said like, you know, she would give it all back, the subscribers or whatever, she didn't mention the money. And I agree with FaZe Banks on this, like, he mentioned that she should donate some of that money to charity, right? He said that she should show her numbers, and like, she's not the president of the United States, I don't need to see the numbers. But the reality is that there is a lot of money that was gained, because even though she's losing subscribers now, she's still coming out on top, millions and millions of subscribers, all right? So yeah, but I think it would be a good thing to do, you know, because she has made a ton of money on this situation. And in my opinion, she could even do this in private, but that's the thing. You can't even do something like this in private because you have to show everybody, no, I just didn't keep all that money. But yeah, it's kind of like blood money. Like, she made this money off of a bad, bad, bad situation. Next, let's talk about Jeffree Star. All right, and it's crazy just seeing how reactionary everybody is to these situations. Jeffree Star, like, I've been rough on him in my videos, but I empathize with Jeffree Star more than a lot of people probably know. And if you pay attention to my videos, like, I can relate to him. I mentioned in one of my last videos, like, he mentions that old Jeffree wanting to come out. I have that old Chris that wants to come out, that angry, angry Chris, all right? But in my opinion, Jeffree Star, he's been in this autopilot mode, right? Like, this dude is a millionaire for a reason, and he is on top of it with his brand. Like, the way he is just constantly on Snapchat, on Instagram, YouTube, Twitter, everything, right? And you get into this autopilot, and something that I think we all forget is that these are all human beings. They have the same brain functions as the rest of us, okay? And what happens is that you get into this autopilot, I've become victim of it as well, and you just post and tweet and share everything out there, and then you're like, oh crap, I can't really take that back, right? And Jeffree Star, he started gaining subscribers and now he's losing them again, and a bunch of people are, you know, talking about the serious allegations he made towards James Charles and everything like that. But at the end of the day, just hopefully Jeffree learns from this situation. Like, and I empathize with him in this situation because actions speak louder than words, all right? I've been sober for almost 7 years and I still screw up. I still screw up. And there are people out there where when I screw up, they're like, oh, you haven't changed at all. You know what I mean? So I get it. And I don't know what it is that Jeffree needs to do. Like, I attend 12-step meetings. I have a sponsor. I have a therapist. And something that we say in the 12-step community is progress, not perfection. But the more you grow on this platform, the more of a responsibility you have to be mindful of what you're posting, what you're tweeting, the text messages you're sending to other people. Like Jeffree got all caught up in that. But at the end of the day, Jeffree Star is still going to make millions and millions and millions and millions of dollars every single year because he makes a good product and he is a great businessman. You know what I mean? Now, James Charles. James Charles is probably the biggest loser in all of this situation. Not like a loser as a person, but like, he lost in this situation. And it is crazy. And I'm glad to see that he's been somewhat vindicated, right? And he came out with just probably the best comeback video like in YouTube history, just debunking all of the major allegations and everything like that. And man, like, it was awesome. But at the end of the day, he still lost. Like, one of the worst things that could ever happen to any of us is have people that we thought were friends just turn on us. Like, it was bad enough that two of James Charles' mentors turned on him. Like, that's almost like your parents turning on you, right? Like, and James Charles screwed up. So I do hope James Charles learns from this situation, because James Charles massively screwed up. And I think this took him down a few notches, and hopefully we see him grow as a person. But not only did his two mentors turn on him, but like, all of the channels were like making videos, or it was becoming news for every single friend of James Charles just systematically unfollowing him. And like, think about that for a second. Like, put yourself in his shoes. Like, could you imagine a rumor going around and all of your friends just not even talking to you and asking you about it? They just totally left you. Like, James Charles is going to have so many trust issues. That kid is 19 years old. 19 years old. He is going to have such a problem trusting people, right? And mentors and friends aside, but like, his love life too. You know what I mean? Two guys who consented to hooking up with him have become very public about it. You know what I mean? He has to question every move he makes from now going forward, all right? And that really sucks. That really sucks, but it's part of the deal with this whole thing. And at the end of the day, at the end of the day, this is like, this is gonna be a controversial thing that I say, but this is probably one of the best things to happen to James Charles. And the reason being, I guarantee you guys are gonna see in years to come, like, I think James Charles is gonna become the new Jeffree Star, but hopefully better, all right? Because he's gonna learn so much from this situation. Like, I look back at my past and the horrible things that have happened to me and that I've been through, but they've made me a stronger, better, wiser person. So I do think James Charles is going to come out on top of this entire situation. Next, something that people haven't been talking about, which has been on my mind, like in the back of my mind this whole time, is Shane Dawson. Shane frickin' Dawson. Can you imagine? Can you imagine what's going on in Shane's mind? Like, do you remember when Shane Dawson just used to make videos with like Garrett and Drew and just having fun and goofing around and stuff like that? Do you guys remember those good old days? Like when you heard Shane and Friends, it was like Shane and Ryland and Drew and Garrett. Morgan might have been up in the mix. Now they got Andrew up in there. All these things, right? Like that was Shane and Friends. But Shane, you know, is, I was thinking about making a whole video on this. Shane is, he's attracted to problematic people. And this was discussed heavily in his series about Jake Paul when he was talking with Katie Morton. Like, Shane Dawson wants to be like the good influence for these bad people. And he wants to be somebody who can, you know, be there for these people who he knows are problematic. And I can only imagine what this has been doing to Shane's mind, because he did the collab with Jeffree Star, that little docu-series, and then they kind of talked about doing a makeup project together, and now it's been confirmed that it's actually happening, and Shane Dawson is diving into the whole beauty community thing, and like, imagine that. Imagine showing up to a new job and then just seeing all this drama happening. You're like, oh my God, right? And I think it's gonna be interesting. And I wonder how Shane's been dealing with this behind the scenes and what he's been talking to them about and everything like that. Like, Shane is gonna be fine no matter what. His audience, his fans are so diehard and loyal. They're gonna be there for him. But I'm sure he's questioning a lot of things now. A lot of things now that everything's out on the table. And granted, Shane probably knows more stuff behind the scenes than we do, but it's still gotta be taking its toll on that dude's mental health, and it is rough. The last section I wanna talk about is the fans, the audience, the community, right? I have seen so many comments on my videos, on Twitter, just everywhere, and like, the fans are the ones who get screwed on this thing, man. Like, it's crazy. Like, I'm not, you know, I've made some videos like doing my makeup and stuff like that, you know, whatever, just for fun, but like, I was first introduced to this community by my girlfriend and her best friend and everything like that, and I know there's a bunch of, you know, women and men out there who love playing with makeup and everything. They just want to watch these videos about like makeup artists doing makeup and learning new things and everything like that. And this keeps happening. And like, it would be insane for anybody to think that this is the last time it's happening, right? Like I mentioned in another video, like this is my second year following the beauty community, and it's 2 for 2. Last year was a situation with Manny MUA and Laura Lee and, you know, Jeffree Star and all those people. And now we have this year. Like, I have a feeling it's gonna happen next year as well. And the fans have been completely screwed. And something my girlfriend was talking to me about, which I've seen other people, I've seen so many people say this too. Like, she doesn't even like watching beauty channels anymore. Like, she just doesn't. Like, this was like her thing, right? Like, she watched them while she got ready. You know, even if she wasn't following a tutorial, she just likes listening to them. She would tell me that it's like kind of soothing and everything like that. She was telling me that, you know, she even would like fall asleep to videos like Tati Westbrook because she has a very soothing and calming voice and everything. But it's like, for her, and I've seen many other people say this, like the experience has just been ruined. Right? And like, I talked to him, like, you know, what about your girl like that Taylor, like, who's like not problematic, never up in this stuff or anything like that, or like Glam and Gore, like Mikey, she's never up in this stuff, but she's taking a break right now. And like, my girlfriend was saying, like, just whenever she turns on a beauty video, like, she's reminded of all this stuff and she can't help but wonder all these other things going on behind the scenes. And like, yeah, that sucks. That sucks for everybody involved, and it sucks for the community. And in my opinion, I think that's what makes YouTube a way different platform than any other form of celebrity, right? Because celebrities are able to keep so many things behind closed doors, but in the age of building on social media platforms, like the way you connect and build that brand is by letting them into your life, right? And what we've seen in this whole situation is that in some circumstances, people react rather than respond, and it could just kick off this insanely huge controversy. You know what I mean? So I would love to hear your thoughts down in the comments below. Like, how much do you think YouTubers and beauty gurus or people like myself should actually share? Because I'm sure on your end, it helps you connect with people like us, but how much do you really want to know about? You know what I mean? It's just a bunch of things that I've been thinking about throughout this entire situation, all right? But anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell because I make a ton of videos. And a huge, huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You're all amazing. And if you would like to become a patron, get involved in our monthly Q&A, get your name in the credits, help support what I'm doing here, click or tap on that Patreon icon right there, all right? Thanks again so, so much for watching. I'll see you next time.